Hey guys, today I'm going to share with you how I studied for the TEAS test. I just took it this last week and I did very well. I scored in the 97th percentile, which was very exciting for me. I put a lot of work in, and I'll be sharing with you how I studied, what book I used, and some of the advice that I have on how to get a great score and how to efficiently study so that you're focusing on what you need to learn and not what you already know. So to get started, the book that I used is the ATI TEAS Secrets Study Guide. The great part about this book is that it has all the information that you need to know. It basically goes through each section. The first section of the TEAS test is the reading section. The second section is the math section. Then they have the science section and then the English language and usage section. So it goes through all those four sections, breaks down every single thing that you need to know in the test, and some things in more detail, some in less, but it's all very concise and very helpful. Then at the very end of the book, they have three full-length practice tests. So this book is an awesome resource because it is kind of like an all-in-one. You don't actually really need anything else besides this, which is great, unless you want to and unless that helps you. So I would highly recommend this book. So what I did to study for the test, and what I think is most efficient, is to choose exactly which sections you need to focus on the most. So for me, I have not actually taken any math courses or any science courses for the past 11 years since high school. My previous degree was in music, and so I had a lot of other classes, but not math and science. So I knew that those were the ones that I really needed to focus on the most. So I took the math section in this book, and I took the science section in this book, and I literally went through it, read the entire thing, did all the practice questions that they had, and then any sections that I came to that I didn't know as well, that I knew that I needed more review on, I would make into a flashcard. And the flashcard app that I used that I would highly recommend is called Anki. Anki is a spaced repetition app, and what that means is that your flashcards are spaced out based on how well you know them. And so if you need to review a flashcard a lot and something that you are not very confident in, you'll review it very frequently. So maybe every day. As you get more confident with certain concepts, then you'll start spacing it out more and more. So it'll be once a week and then once a month. It focuses on the problem areas and what you really need to study. Another perk about Anki is that you can put in diagrams, you can put in pictures, you can make voice memos. There's even more that I have not used yet, like you can blank out words and things like that. So that is a great way to review. Another resource that I use that's free is Khan Academy. And I use Khan Academy especially for science concepts that I was not very familiar with. So for example, when I started reading about the kidneys, I went to Khan Academy and I watched how, for example, like the video on nephrons, and that really helped me to understand what I needed to know for the TEAS test a little bit more in depth and more in detail. So I would highly recommend Khan Academy. They have resources for pretty much all the areas of the TEAS test that are very great. So after I had finished working through the ATI Secrets study guide, then, and I knew that I had gotten most of the information that I needed, then I went to the practice tests, and I did two practice tests. I used one from this book and then one from another book that I'll show you. So they have three practice tests at the back of this book, which are great. Now, in retrospect, now that I've actually taken the TEAS test, I can say these are very similar to the actual TEAS test, and I think they're a really great way to get ready for the test. So they have a practice test, and they have it broken down into the four sections: reading, then math, then science, and then the English language and usage. And they give you the amount of time that you have for each one, and so you can actually mimic the actual test setting, take the whole test, has an answer key at the end, and in the answer key, it's also very helpful because they have explanations for each answer. So if you get something wrong, you can also go ahead and read what the answer is and why it is correct. So this is a great resource. I did one practice test from here, and then felt like I needed just another practice test to make sure that I was prepared. And so I had gotten this test book from a friend, this practice test book, and it also was really good. For this one, I felt like the science section was harder, and that was really good for me because it challenged me and helped me to prepare on that science section, I think, a little bit better. So this is the McGraw-Hill Education 5 T's practice test. This is also, I think, a really great resource to have. Again, I only did one test from here and then one of the practice tests from the ATI Secrets Study Guide. And so those two tests helped me to prepare well. I got pretty good scores on both of my practice tests and very similar to what I got on the actual test when I took it. So I feel like those two are very comparable to each other. My total score on the test was 87.3%. My reading score was 93.6%. Math score was 96.9. Science score was 72.3. And then English and language usage was 87.5. So my total score scored in the 97th percentile for the national average. And my school that I am applying to, the nursing program, they require that you at least have a 51 on the science and then get at least a 64 total. So I was in a good range for that, and I was very pleased overall with my score. All right, so those are my biggest tips and tricks for how to prepare for the TEAS test. I think the best thing is to get this ATI TEAS Secrets book. If there's just one thing that you invest in, I would recommend it being this, because this really, really has all the information you need to know, and it also has practice tests inside of it. So it's kind of a everything all in one in this guide. And if you want to get some extra help, some extra practice tests, this is also a great resource as well. The 5 T's Practice Test by McGraw-Hill. And while you're studying, I would recommend using the Anki flashcard app or some other type of spaced repetition app, because that's a really great way to review what you already know and to continue to review it, but also to focus especially on the things that you are not quite as confident in or maybe need a little extra help on. So I'll link all of these things below. If you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and subscribe. I'll be having more videos on pre-nursing and nursing, on study tips and advice that I have along the way. So go ahead and subscribe, and I hope you enjoyed this video.